Welcome to Modular Classroom. Today in Artificial Intelligence series planning, we are going to see about Sussman anomaly. So as we saw in the last video, goal stack planning, it may fail to find a good solution for some problem. So a slightly harder block problems cannot deal with goal stack planning. That comes with the help called the Sussman algorithm. The start state is looking like this, that is on C, A and on table A of A and on table of B and arm empty. Goal state is you have to place all the blocks one within another, that is on A, B and on B, C. So to achieve this goal state, you have two alternatives as shown in the slide. Next, we are choosing the first alternative to get block A on block B. Now your goal stack will be produced like this. This is a precondition of unstack, precondition of pickup and precondition of stack. Now your goal stack look like this. Here, to achieve this arm empty, you have to precondition called pickup of A to be satisfied. So to achieve pickup of A, you have to put down of C. Then pop up the goal stack. Now it will, current state will look like on table of B and on A, B and on table of C and arm empty. So till now, the sequence of operator you have applied is unstack of C, A, put down of C, pickup of A and stack of A, B. Next, go for the second option on B, C. Same procedure continues and your operator, the state and the problem state will be on B, C and on table of A and on table of C and arm empty. The remaining goal stack is like this. This sequence of operators you have applied is pickup of A and stack of A, B. Now they combined all together, you just combine all the two procedures goal till you will get 10 steps, that is unstack C, A to stack A, B. Analyzing the sequence, you can observe that step 4 and 5 are opposites and therefore you can cancel each other. Step 3 and 6 are opposites and you can cancel each other. After cancelling the final step, you will get come to the right side, unstack C, A, put down of C, pickup of B, stack B, C, pickup of A, stack A, B. This is the final plan. So it contains a minimum number of operators to solve the harder problem. This is achieved by the Sussman anomaly. The next topic is nonlinear planning using constraint posting. The goal stack planning method attacks problems involving conjoined goals by solving the goals one at a time in order. Plan generated by this method contains sequence of operators to achieve the first goal followed by the sequence for the second goal. But it may lead to you some difficult problems where the goal interactions are achieved. So you cannot apply the goal stack planning for non-linear problems. You cannot apply that. So such a plan is called non-linear because it is not composed of a linear sequence of complete sub-plans. You cannot able to follow linearly. For that kind of problems, you are using the concept called constraint posting. Constraint posting look like some operators you will want to use. They are called as tweak heuristics. They are the first planning method heuristic is step addition, that is creating new steps for a plan. Second is promotion, constraining a step to go before another step. Deglobbering, you're placing a new step between the two steps to revert a precondition. Simple establishment, assigning a value to a variable to ensure a precondition. And fifth one is separation, preventing variables being assigned certain values. Using these five tweak heuristics, you will achieve a plan for constraint posting. This is called as constraint since, look at this diagram, within stack of A, B, it has been divided into two blocks. One is above the line and below the line. Above the line, you can say that is the precondition, and followed by the line, you can call it as a postcondition. So look at here, pickup of A, preconditions are all clear of A, on table of A and arm empty. And pickup of B is also similarly below that line, as you call it as a postcondition. So here in this case, to state that a pickup step should precede a corresponding stack, you have to do this, that is you are promoting this step to go before this step. So in this diagram, you can able to see four steps are partially ordered and they are four unachieved condition. The star indicate that it is been unconditioned, it is not achieved. You cannot able to give a conclusion from this step. So you have to use a promotion heuristic to force one operator to precede another. So then the postcondition of one operator stack of A comma B does not negate the precondition clear of B, another operator pickup of B. So it is being represented by using a promotion. Likewise, the globbering step is used to achieve the preconditions of the second operator. So promotion and deglobbering are being applied in this, heuristics are being applied here. Here you are using the step addition by using the operator x and stack of x comma a, you are adding one additional step. Then x, that particular x step, you can able to bound with the simple heuristic, establishment heuristic operator. So three ordering will be produced to ensure the operator unstuck c comma a. And finally, so final sequence is unstack c comma a to stack a comma b, your goal state will be achieved. So this is algorithm that is followed in nonlinear planning. Next one is hierarchical planning. To solve order problems, you have to generate long plans. To do efficiently, a BSIPS approach is being followed. Example, this is the operator and this is a precondition and this is a postcondition. In real time example, just you take your friend want to visit another friend in Europe, you have a limited amount of cash to spend. First of all, for that you have, that particular person has to check whether he has amount for the airfare, then an affordable flight within that amount of cash, then you have to plan for going from the airport to his friend's place, etc. That likewise a step by step planning he should carry over. That has been also called as length first search. Reactive systems, the next topic. Till now we have seen about hierarchical planning and non-linear planning, where the planning process is being constructed prior to the action. In action it does not do anything, but in reactive system that particular process, particular planning is conducted according to that observable situation, is called the reactive system. Example, you can take with the help of thermostat. The job of the thermostat is to keep temperature constant inside a room. So it uses a simple rule called a situation action rule. So if the temperature in the room is k degrees above the desired temperature, then turn the air condition on. If the temperature in the room is k degrees below the desired temperature, then turn the air condition off. So it acts according to the situation. That is called as a reactive system. The advantage of the reactive system is robustness and extremely responsive. So whenever for the real time systems, you will use this reactive system. Thank you for watching.